the view from one of the towers that is Alton Towers, once a stately home in Victorian times, but now Britain's biggest theme park, and where today one man will take home the Energizer Battery Trophy and be crowned Britain's strongest man.
Ultimate ride experience, Nemesis, the goddess of retribution. And for the 8 finalists, today is the moment of truth.
The format of the Energizer Battery Trophy, 8 contestants, 7 events. First up, Brian Bell, 32 years old, a bus driver. Graham Mullins is 33, he's a lorry driver. Glenn Ross, 28, and a chef. Colin Bryce is 24 and a TV researcher. Bill Pittuck, 36 years old, a brewer. Lee Bowers, 31, and a meat porter. Jamie Bars, 34, a student at university in Scotland. And Steve Brooks is 33. He runs his own health food shop. It's going to be hot work today. Glorious blue skies, a warm sun, and the final of Britain's Strongest Man begins in front of the castle. Well, this first event is the only one in which all 8 finalists compete against each other. It's a game of 3 halves. The first section, you have to run and pick up this beer barrel that weighs a mere 105 kilograms and carry it down the course and stick it on a sledge at the end. And then you run back and make no mistake, some of these guys can run and pick up the sandbag that weighs 95 kilograms and bring that up here and stick that on the sledge as well. The sledge weighs 30 kilograms in its own right. That's a combined total of 230 kilograms overall. 37 and a half stone to you and me, and you drag the whole lot back to the end of the course, and the first one home wins. And commentary comes from Paul Dickinson.
Tremendous nervousness out there on the course.
Mullins, Maltby, South Yorks.
The big Yorkshireman, Mullins.
Stephen Brooks.
Then Stephen Brooks from County Durham. An enormous man.
Glasgow.
Colin Bryce, a Scot now working in London.
Bill Pittuck, Northampton.
He's one of the most experienced men here.
Jamie Barr, White.
And Jamie Barr, who won the final heat.
Lee Bowers, Airby, Lanx.
Lee Bowers has competed in World's Strongest
Brian
Man
Bell,
before.
Dundee.
And so has Brian Bell. And the biggest
Glenn
man
Ross,
of all, Glenn Ross from County Down. And just before the event started, Gary Richardson caught up with one or two competitors.
Looking at the barrels, it's a home for home from you because you carry them around at work all
day,
don't you?
Yeah, a bit of an advantage, yeah, because I pick them up every day, so.
Thank you for the flowers, Jimmy.
Yeah, you don't ever drink what's in them when you're at work?
No, I can't stand that.
No, because you work for a lager company, we won't say which one.
No, I won't say no. Probably the best.
In the world. who's going to be your main rivals today?
I think the lighter lads, Colin Bryce, Jamie Barr. But might be surprised, Glenn Ross is fairly quick for a big man, so. I wouldn't like to say, really.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I think it's my kind of event. I've got a chance to gain some points here. You know, any event that's faster and, let's say, lighter than the static, slow events, I've got a chance.
You're a quick man then, are you?
Quicker. Yeah.
Well, I'm not sure there's a big sprinter out there, but we'll wait and see. It's certainly a lot to do with fitness. Away we go. The first event in the 1999 final of Britain's Strongest Man, and Bill Pittuck is absolutely flying. Colin Bryce is there too, so is Lee Bowers. Back they go for the sack. Brian Bell going as fast as he can. Steve Brooks just picking up the sack. Bill Pittuck is being caught by Colin Bryce. Well, Bryce on the right-hand side in the blue vest, a surprise finalist. There's Jamie Barr in the red. It's Pittuck who's away first. Bryce having difficulty getting that sled moving. Glenn Ross just beginning his pull. Lee Bowers catching a little bit. Ross, who won his heat, is way behind. I think Jamie Barr's going to take it. What has Barr got left over the last meter? Jamie Barr just wins it. Bill Pittuck about to finish in second place. Well done to him. Lee Bowers finishes now just ahead of Graham Mullins. Now, who's going to get the small points at the end? Oh, Glenn Ross pulling it while he's still on the ground. Then Brian Bell. It's been a very tough one. Colin Bryce, the last man out on the course. The lightest man in this final, so I guess he was always going to find this one tough. Just a single point for Colin Bryce. Oh, what about Steve Brooks? 5 points for him.
Well, I knew Bill. I'd watched him do it in the heats. I knew he was quick and he went away, miles away, but the thing that they failed in the heats on was the sledge. So my idea, paced myself with a sack in the barrel and then bust my ass doing the sledge, and it paid off. So I should have paced myself a little bit on the first run. I fired off a bit too quick, I think, and it let me down and dragged back. I lost a bit of power there, but second's good. I said Jamie, but I didn't know. I wish I'd have said that then. Today's a good day for me. Tomorrow I'll not get many points, so I've got to get as many as I can today.
A flying start for Jamie Barr, but as he said there, he knows this is a marathon, not a sprint. Now let's face it, it wouldn't be a strongman event without some trucks. We've got two.
Some people say a man is made out of mud, a poor man's made out of muscle and blood and skin and bone, a mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You pull 16 tons and what do you get? Next event.
The course here is 30 metres long and this is real pressure on arms and legs.
Colin Bryce, the first to go, getting strapped in at the head of that track and disappointed, I think, with his performance in the carry and drag.
I should have tried the equipment beforehand. It was a shock. I thought I'd just gentle ease into it and start pulling it and then accelerate. I just couldn't pull it at all, so, yeah.
Of course, it didn't have wheels on. The things you're about to pull have got wheels on, but between them, they weigh 16 tonnes.
Don't remind me, I've never done this before, so I'll try my best.
Well, if he thinks the carry and drag was a shock, just wait until he starts to pull this.
Are you ready?
Yep. Technique is involved as well. They've got to stay low. Grip on the ground is so important. I think Colin is actually wearing some special climbing boots, and that should help just a little. I promise you, everything is going to hurt at the end of this event. The arms from pulling the rope. As John Inverdell was saying, the legs as well. And the heart and lungs will be working overtime. Coming up towards 30 seconds. This is a real gutsy effort by Colin Bryce. He's not the heaviest of men, but he's very, very powerful. He does a lot of running in his training, which is actually unusual for a guy this size. The truck goes past 25 metres. Being roared on by the crowd, being encouraged by Jamie Reeve, standing on the right-hand side there, a former World's Strongest Man. The truck has got to reach the line. It's so close now. And he gets it. Just under a minute for Colin Bryce. Oh, well, certainly a disadvantage to go first. That is what everybody else will be aiming for.
You just keep your legs pumping. Keep breathing deep. Oh, well, inches away from not making it there.
Under a minute, though, 58 seconds.
Really? Oh, a bit of hope, maybe.
And tell us, when you started, did you feel, my goodness, there's loads of people watching, I'm not going to get going at all, and the trucks are going to stay right where they are? Did that ever go through your head?
My worst nightmare. I didn't sleep last night. I just saw myself pulling and pulling for a minute and a half, like an idiot, but oh well.
You set the standard.
Thank you.
Brian Bell now, one of the most experienced men in this final. 20 stones of solid muscle.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Hit the strain.
He's got the climbing boots on as well. And this fella once broke a world record for the bench press exercise, nearly 600 pounds. Those massive arms are so, so strong. He's got his knees strapped as well. That will help. And Brian Bell is actually making tremendous progress. He came seventh in the first event, and that carried just 2 points, so he needs a good performance here. Oh, it's phenomenal by Brian Bell. 25 metres, just five to go. He's so far ahead of Colin Bryce, that's for sure. It's going to be a very quick time. Absolutely fantastic. 43.47 seconds for Brian Bell. Fantastic for the Scot.
Brian Bell's time was 43.47 seconds.
How do you react to that then?
It was very difficult, but I enjoyed Pittuck Pure. It's better than Cali and Drag.
Are you surprised at the time?
I've never actually pulled two trucks, so I'm quite surprised, yeah.
And you've set the standard, haven't you? 43 seconds.
Yeah, I've given all the rest a time to chase now.
Will they get close to it, do you think?
Well, I hope not, but you never know.
Well, Glenn Ross got close, but not close enough. His time, 45.35 seconds. And Graham Mullins really found it tough going. 51.22 was his time.
Take the rope.
Steve Brooks now, the man with muscles bulging everywhere. The pride and joy of Spennymoor in County Durham.
Ready?
He loves this event as well. He really does fancy his chances. But what a performance by Brian Bell. 43.47 seconds. Well, Steve Brooks off to a very good start here. Sails past 5 metres and past 10 metres. His wife Lynn will be in the crowd, feeling as nervous as ever, and Steve Brooks is accelerating. He's getting faster. Taking short steps is so important. He's got the technique absolutely perfect on this occasion. He really is chasing Brian Bell's time. He's giving it everything, slowing down just a shade here. It's going to be so, so close. Oh, he's just outside, 44 seconds, but he goes into second place. A tremendous start for Steve Brooks in his first ever Britain's Strongest Man final.
But Brian Bell clocked a time of 47.16. So that left just one man to try and win the truck pull.
Are you ready, Bill?
Well, the rest of the competitors will be sweating just a little bit, especially Brian Bell and Steve Brooks, as Bill Pittuck gets away. Now, Bill Pittuck has competed in this event at World's Strongest Man level before. He's not taking short, fast steps like we saw from Steve Brooks, slightly longer, and probably using the arms to great effect as well. This man who won his heat, beating Lee Bowers into second place and coming back from a long period of injury, desperately would love to win this title. The target, 43.47 seconds, is going to be very, very close. Oh, Brian Bell has won it. And I think Steve Brooks is safe in second place. That is a good start, though, by Bill Pittuck. Third place for sure. Oh, staggers to his feet, but a great
Bill
performer.
Pittuck's time was 45.12 seconds.
So everybody completed the course, but Brian Bell's time proved unbeatable, half a second clear of the rest.
43:47, the time was good enough.
Yeah, it was good enough from the start. Like, it's always difficult going first because everyone's got your time to go for. But I knew I could be close to winning it. Like, that's the first time I've actually pulled two trucks together, so I'm quite pleased to come out on top on that one.
Well, this looks like it could be a really close competition. 5 points separating the top six after two events. So here we are in the courtyard of Alton Towers for another old favourite of strongman events. Let's face it, if you're not pulling trucks, you're lifting stones. And this involves five stones weighing between 95 and 135 kilograms being lifted onto their designated spots on top of a wall.
In blue,
Graham Mullins on the right-hand side and Colin Bryce on the left. Well, so far, Colin Bryce has found life a little bit difficult in his first ever Britain's Strongest Men final. Graham Mullins, much, much bigger than Colin. There's a huge difference in their physiques.
Ready? On the whistle.
Five stones to go. I'm not sure either of these two guys has ever lifted all five. Tremendous start by Colin Bryce. Oh, Graham Mullins in all sorts of problems. That first part of the wall is over 6 feet. And Colin Bryce has got the technique off to a fine art. Already one stone ahead of Graham Mullins. Mullins, the gritty Yorkshireman, Bryce the Scot. That one's safely up for Mullins. Well, Colin Bryce is going very well indeed here. And the timekeepers will be taking the time that each stone is successfully placed on top of the wall in case there is a tie. Oh, that's his first mistake. He's all over the place. Graham Mullins just having a little glance across there. They're now equal on stones, but Bryce ahead on time. This could go down as Bryce's best performance so far in the final. There's a long way to go, though. And this is where exhaustion really takes its toll, but that was a tremendous performance by Graham Mullins. He now moves ahead of Colin Bryce. Jamie Reeves, the judge on this side, knows this man very well indeed, and certainly he'll be giving him just a few tips. Can he get five on board? This is Colin Bryce, fourth. I think they've just about had enough. So, first blood goes to Graham Mullins. Frustration for Colin Bryce.
4:68. How good is that?
That's pathetic. I did 4 in about 50 seconds in the heat. But it's been a very long day. I don't think there's an ounce of strength left in my legs. My back, I think my back's at home somewhere. I don't know where my back is. And energy levels are probably zero. It's just pure willpower and determination that drove it on. But I wanted that first time.
Lee Bowers
from Lancashire. And he's done this event before too, as has Jamie Barr. I suspect out of the two of them, Jamie Barr the most experienced. And Jamie Barr, one of the joint leaders with Steve Brooks overall. It's a beautiful day here at Alton Towers. Tremendous crowds too. Oh, almost together. Easy does it. Lee Bowers just crunching himself against the wall with that first stone, but gets it up successfully. Jamie Barr, 12 points in total from the first two events. Lee Bowers just rolls that up his chest. And that second stone there weighs about 16.5 stones. Well, we've yet to see a man get all five up in this final. Colin Bryce got 3 stones up in 27.5 seconds. I think Jamie Barr has moved ahead of that target easily. The next target is 4 by Graham Mullins. And Jamie Barr is deceptively strong. He actually weighs about 19.5 stones, but he doesn't look it. And that is 4. Faster than Graham Mullins, so he moves into the lead. Lee Bowers struggling just a wee bit. It's Lancashire up against Scotland at the moment. Lee Bowers from Colne in Lancashire 20 stones and 6 feet tall. He can't wrap his arms around that ball. Now, come on, Jamie. One more to go. A massive effort, and he could do it. Barr on the far side has actually got his arms heavily strapped because this thing really does scrape the arm, something terrible. Jamie Barr takes the lead in this third event. Just confirming his time and performance.
Jamie, you were so close to getting all five up, but you didn't quite make it in the end.
Just run out of steam, man. Just tired. That's three hard events we've had today. Main thing is I beat Mullins. Sassenach.
Two awesome figures up next. Glenn Ross from Northern Ireland. 10 stones heavier than Bill Pittuck. It seems almost unbelievable.
Ready.
Now, what sort of endurance have they both got? Certainly, Glenn Ross showed us in his heat that although he's a big man, he can move pretty well. Bill Pittuck, as we already know, having seen him in this first event, is a real sprinter. And it's Pittuck who moves ahead first. A lot of the competitors put tacky, some very sticky stuff indeed, on their forearms to help with the grip, and it seems to be helping these two. It's Jamie Barr in the lead at the moment. Nobody has lifted all five, though. And look at this, Glenn Ross is moving ahead of Bill Pittuck. Tremendous performance by Glenn Ross. Pittuck gets three up as well. And Glenn Ross is moving like a train now, just one to go, and he could win it with this one. Bill Pittuck just struggling just a little bit, and he's done it! Just making sure it stayed on top of the wall. Oh, yes. Well, Bill Pittuck has still got a lot of work to do. Trying to get on level terms with Jamie Barr and Brian Bell. Can't do it. Graham Mullins got four up as well, so a bad performance there for Bill Pittuck, but brilliant by Glenn Ross.
That was easy, wasn't it?
The stones are never easy. Never easy. I'm just pleased to... I mean, look who I'm up against. To get all five up.
And you did all five in under a minute.
Well, I've just been watching the biggest stone lift in the world, Lazo Fekete. He's a wee bit of a belly too. He rests on his chest, flips him up with his gut. And I've been practicing that, so that's been working.
The final pair, Steve Brooks. Chasing an incredible lead, 55.90 seconds. The same for Brian Bell.
Ready.
I saw Brian Bell do an exhibition of this stone lifting in Scotland once upon a time, and he did five with ease. Steve Brooks there hoisting it onto his shoulder. It's almost a case of the tortoise and the hare in this event. There's no point in going off too quickly because you're definitely going to run out of steam by the time you get to the fifth stone. And Steve Brooks is going well, though. 2 stones ahead of Brian Bell. Jamie Barr at the moment is in second place. 4 stones in 54 and a bit seconds. Brian Bell's third, just. And Steve Brooks has done it. Oh, yes, come on, he says, more support. He might be wasting a little bit of time doing that, though. Perhaps Glenn Ross heading towards his first victory in this final. Steve Brooks running out of time. And he's got it. He's going to get second place. Glenn Ross has won by over 14 seconds. And what can Brian Bell do? He can't quite make the fifth stone, and I think his time for four is slower than Jamie Barr. It certainly is by a couple of seconds, so Bell down in fourth place.
Well, that really was a fantastic performance for a man with a bad back.
Yeah, I just blocked it out. I was in two minds to do it or not in the tent.
Second fastest time of the day as well.
Second fastest. Yeah, it felt good. Hopefully I'll stay in first position tomorrow. Yeah, another two good events for Sunday. Just have to dig in, keep it there.
Only Ross and Brooks managed all 5 stones, but Ireland's strongest man in a class of his own, 14 seconds clear of the rest. Brooks scoring consistently at the top, Ross up from sixth to third, and with the exception of Colin Bryce, it's anybody's race.
Well, these guys have got thighs like tree trunks, and now they've got to lift one. Some small acorn sometime produced this mighty oak that weighs 60 stone, and they've got 90 seconds to lift it from their chest, over their head, locking out the arms as often as they can. Log on with Britain's Strongest Man.
All the competitors I talk to, nobody seems to like this event.
They're all lying. It's only me that's not any good at this. Me and Colin will be fighting for last place here, because we both did 10 in the heats, so we'll just have to wait and see. It's like everything else. Everybody says this or that, the next thing. The proof of the pudding's when you actually do it.
Talking to one of the competitors, he said anybody that does 17, they'll probably win it.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I'd reckon Glenn would be the winner here for this event. Suits him, static. Static events suit Graham.
Hopefully it should be my day this today, you know. Par events, my game, like. Sort of relying on these par events to get my points up in this competition, to give me a chance of winning it, like.
Bill Pittuck, Northampton.
Go on, Bill. Bill Pittuck, a gritty competitor, and he's going to need all his experience and determination in this one. The weight that is bearing down on the shoulders is about 17 and a half stones.
Lift. One, wait for the count.
Oh, he's been told by Dougie Edmonds just to wait, but that one was counted. He's up to three already.
Four. Five.
He's not wasting any time at all. And this is good technique.
Seven.
Little push from the knees as well. That always helps.
Nine.
And John Inverdale was saying that most of these guys...
40.
And this is a very good performance indeed. Is he going to get 15? Yes, he does. Squeeze one more out, not quite, but that is a tremendous performance by Bill Pittuck. Very disappointed in the last event. He set a very tough standard for everybody else. I've only seen this event a couple of times before, but that's one of the biggest totals I've seen, that's for sure.
I've never done it before. It's a bit strange. Very strict, you know, you have to hold it for a count and put it down, but I'm pleased with that 15. That set the lads a record to go for.
Is it going to be enough to do it?
I doubt it. There's some big presses in there. But I'm pleased with that. That should pull me up there.
Well, Lee Bowers is one of the big pressers. And being told by Jamie Reeves exactly what is required as far as the technique is concerned. All these competitors under the watchful eye of Dougie Edmonds, and he stands no nonsense, I can promise you that.
Left.
The log has to go to arm's length, and then it must come down just below the chin. Oh, it looks so easy. That's 110 kilos. Five times so far for Lee Bowers. He's about 6 feet tall. And 20 stones in body weight. And he's making this log look so easy. Chasing the lead of Bill Pittuck at 15. Glenn Ross it was, who lifted it 18 times in the heats. We've yet to see him.
14.
One more brings him level with Pittuck.
15.
And he's still looking good. He's still got plenty of puff left as well. He's in the lead.
17.
Oh, tremendous by Lee Bowers. 18. That equals Glenn Ross's phenomenal performance. Now, come on, one more. Oh, tremendous by Lee Bowers. Just ran out of steam in the end. Oh, yes. That is going to be tough for everybody else to beat.
Well, we were impressed with 15, but you've done 18.
Yeah, I wish I could have done a few more, but I have to do something after yesterday's disaster.
It looked fairly easy for you,
yeah.
Surely not.
Yeah, I'm the king of the presses. I don't care what Glenn says.
Well, Colin Bryce certainly isn't king of the presses. Just 11 for him. Graham Mullins managed 13, but struggling for a big man. And Brian Bell, after that good start, could only manage 14 here.
Jamie Barr said he wasn't looking forward to this event, had all sorts of problems with his wrist in the heats. That seems to have cleared up. But there will be an enormous amount of pressure on his hands, his wrists, and his elbows in this event. But Lord Jamie Barr lying in second place overall behind Steve Brooks.
One. Two.
It's been a tremendous standard in this competition so far. Lee Bowers, of course, in the lead with 18. Bill Pittuck with 15.
Five.
Then Brian Bell with 14.
Six.
And Jamie Barr is a very thoughtful character. Likes to figure out the tactics and the technique before every event takes place.
Nine.
He's struggling just a little bit. One more will bring him level with Colin Bryce. Now, can he do it? Oh, that's enough. He wasn't expecting a great deal from this event. Still got time to have a laugh with Jamie Reeves, though. In last place at the moment.
You weren't looking forward to it.
You can see why, yeah? I would tell you what it was, but I'm not allowed to swear on the telly.
Worse than you thought it was going to be?
No, just exactly what I thought it was going to be. Crap.
Last minute instructions from Jamie to Steve Brooks. The wind's blowing quite a lot here at Alton Towers today, but it's still pretty hot and the competition is intense. Now, Steve Brooks had terrible problems in the heats. He wasn't lowering it far enough and he wasn't locking his arms out, but there's no mistake now. The referee disallowed about five lifts in the heats, but so far, so good. And we've been told by the referee that the greatest number of lifts ever in this event is 18, and that's something that Glenn Ross achieved in the heats and Lee Bowers has already done today. Big Edmund saying, take it lower. But Steve Brooks is all right, 14. Grinning his teeth, he's just missed one there. 16, that's a tremendous performance. And he's got 17, by far and away his best performance. And he's in second place behind Lee Bowers. Well, he was all over the place in the heats. That was much better.
I'll stay fit and healthy all minute.
And Glenn Ross is about to come on,
yeah.
And he fancies this, doesn't
he?
Yeah,
Glenn's a good press, no doubt about it. But Glenn's a few points behind me. There's a lot of run events tomorrow, which I'm quick.
Glenn Ross.
The final competitor, Glenn Ross, already the king of the Atlas Stones. Can he become king of the giant log lift? He's already seen Lee Bowers equal his performance in the heats of 18 repetitions.
Lower, please. Lower. Lift.
Well,
one.
Wasted energy at the start there.
Two.
And unlike all the other competitors, Glenn's not bothering to use his legs. So strong are his arms. Those biceps and triceps measure about 24 inches.
Oh,
that's bigger than some people's waists. Heading towards 10. It will be a world record if he can beat 18. And that would be superb points for Glenn Ross. Equal with Brian Bell on 14. Now Bill Pittuck on 15. Chasing Steve Brooks, 17 now. And he gets it. 18, can he do one more? Is he going to allow that one? No, he's not. That means that Lee Bowers and he are absolutely dead level pegging at the moment. Come on, Glenn, one more, and he's got it. A new world record, maximum points for Glenn Ross. And big daddy he is. Two events in a row.
Well, at 18, it looked like you were stuck, but you made it to 19.
Well, just take a deep breath, close my eyes, and the man above give me another one.
So a second win for Ross, ahead of Lee Bowers, who must have thought that was going to be his event. A bad result for Jamie Barr, not unexpectedly so. And Brooks and Ross are now pulling clear of the field, but there are still three events to go. Jamie Barr, though, slipping down the charts.
Well, after four events, these guys are really motoring now, but how much have they got left in the tank? This is another real brute strength event. We're talking upwards of 50 stone here. The guys have to pick up these cars and hold them off the ground for as long as is humanly possible until they break.
You don't care for this next event, do you?
No, not really. It hasn't been very helpful to us in the past. Plus, I've got an extra hindrance on my lower back. Like I've been doing all competition, I'll just hang in there.
You say you've got this back injury, but nevertheless, you're still leading, aren't you?
Yeah, I don't know how.
And Steve Brooks was telling us he doesn't like this one, and yet he's leading. So maybe this could be where he'll slip up.
He said I had a sore back as well.
He said I had a sore back. I
think he's telling porkies.
We don't believe him no more.
No, he's lying to us. We're going to get him.
He's sulking us out.
Well, there's a lot of kidology goes on in this event, but they're all great mates, really. Colin Bryce on the left-hand side in blue and Jamie Barr on the right. The lifting strap's so important to maintain a good grip. Colin Bryce in last place at the moment with 7 points in total. Jamie Barr, third equal. I just wonder, with them standing back to back like that, if they'll be worried or bothered about what the other one is doing. Colin Bryce off to a shaky start. Jamie Barr looking pretty solid. Certainly a disadvantage going first, because then everybody else will know exactly what they've got to do. Oh, Colin's struggling a little bit, heading towards 30 seconds. Jamie Barr still looking pretty steady. Come on, Colin, just a little bit more. Jamie Barr too. Don't bite your tongue off, for goodness sake. Oh, and Colin Bryce is down. Now, I'm sure Jamie Barr knows that. He would have heard the noise. So he wants precious more seconds. We saw a time of over a minute in the heat. If he can get anywhere near to that, it would be phenomenal. He's almost bent double. He's down in 54 seconds. That is a tremendous start by Jamie Barr and a gutsy performance by Colin Bryce. Well, the analysis of that event will go on for many hours yet, I'm sure.
54 seconds. How good a time is that?
Well, it's as good as I could do. You're just going to have to wait and see what the rest of them, but I needed a point, so I had to pull something out of the bag. It's who wants it most. And I needed to make up for my last dismal display, shall we say. So one did one's best.
Graham Mullins this time on the right-hand side. Big man. Brian Bell, about 3 or 4 inches shorter than Mullins.
Graham, are you ready? Brian, are you ready?
Both men ready. Mullins lying in seventh place overall. Brian Bell equal third with Bill Pittuck. Bell looking solid. Mullins looking solid. Graham Mullins did ever so well in the heats at this event, but shifting around the platform, he doesn't want to do that. He's asking for the time. He wants to be told exactly what the clock is saying. They know exactly what they've got to beat. It's Jamie Barr's 54 seconds they're aiming for. Both men standing at a slight angle. The grip on the feet has got to be pretty good as well. Mullins shouting at himself. Bell a little quieter. Contemplating a possible lead here. Heading towards 50 seconds. This is a good performance by both men. They go past Jamie Barr, and they know it. The time is being shouted out. Oh, Bell goes down just under a minute. Graham Mullins is hanging on for dear life, and he's gone now too. 65 seconds plus for Mullins. Goes down on his knees. He's absolutely exhausted, as is Brian Bell, just being supported there. The doctor comes rushing onto the stage. Have a closer look at Graham Mullins. Oh, my goodness gracious me. It's really taken its toll, this event.
When you're back-to-back with somebody and you can feed off them and you're trying to outwit them in your particular run, it makes it a lot easier than standing out there on your own. But I think the crowd made a big difference as well.
And when they've dropped the car, that encourages you to go on?
It does, yeah, because I was struggling and it was hurting like hell, the back, the breathing. I dug it out to 20. I thought, what? But I hung in there and it feels good now.
Well, it might not feel good in the next minute or so for these guys. Bill Pittuck on the left, Steve Brooks, the overall leader on the right-hand side. The straps are tight. The knee wraps just in the right place. It's a great lead by Graham Mullins at 65.13. These guys are chasing. Here we go. Steve Brooks a little later to rise than Bill Pittuck here. Now, Pittuck is a magnificent power lifter. Steve Brooks bulging with muscles. Both of them looking pretty steady at the moment. Steve Brooks just blowing a little bit. It's important to get oxygen into the lungs. As soon as oxygen debt sets in, that is the end. 30 seconds for both men. And believe me, this is a huge weight. The whole car weighs nearly a ton. So the weight that they're feeling through the hands, well, it's about 800 or 900 pounds or thereabouts. Oh, he's gone. What a surprise. Bill Pittuck down there in 46.26 seconds. Steve Brooks still looking strong, now chasing for the lead. 10 seconds to go for him. If the clock goes past 65 seconds, he's going to beat Graham Mullins. And he's done it. That's a tremendous performance by Steve Brooks, the overall leader after four events, by 1 point from Glenn Ross. And who knows, he may be in the lead after this one too. Tremendous performance by Brooks, being helped off the stage by former World's Strongest Man, Yuka Ahola.
You actually have a car in your back garden that you go out and pick up from time to time, don't you?
Yeah, I've got a couple of cars, one that I carry and one I can pick up from the back and stuff. Yeah, but it's something that I've got quite a good deadlift, and so I'll just work hard here today. Like I say, if you're relying on the crowd cheering and stuff and the buzzing.
So here we go, Glenn Ross on the right-hand side. Lee Bowers, who's a tremendous power lifter, tremendous deadlifter. Should be technically very good at this event, the man on the left-hand side.
Lee, are you ready?
Yes.
Together, on the whistle.
Well, Lee Bowers, only lifting in his socks. He hasn't got any shoes on at all. In powerlifting, that is a recognised way of lifting these sort of weights. Apparently it helps with the position they're in. Oh, Glenn looks totally composed, doesn't he? Absolutely rock solid. Lee Bowers is the one who's moving just a little bit. Well, Steve Brooks' lead, 68.53. Glenn Ross just a point behind overall after the last event, so this is a very important one for him. Just two events to go after this one, and Lee Bowers shaking just a little bit. Perhaps it wasn't such a good idea after all not to put some footwear on. He looked as though he was slipping a little bit there. Ross is still as steady as a rock. Now heading towards a minute. Their first target is Brian Bell's 59.61. They've got it. Now to Graham Mullins, 65 seconds. It's going to be very close. Oh, they move ahead of Mullins. Ross is the first to go. And Lee Bowers has beaten Steve Brooks. Absolutely fantastic. A maximum 8 points for him, and Glenn Ross is in the points once more.
Lee, you made that look as though you were picking up a toy car.
I wouldn't say it was quite easy. The lift isn't the difficult bit about it. It's just the holding on. It's the power, it saps your power.
Because early on when you were shouting for the times, I thought, hello, he's going to pack up after about 20 seconds, but you didn't.
Yeah, well, I just kept on this. Things at stake, got to keep going.
He certainly did. At last, a deserved victory for Lee Bowers, who's now right back in contention. He beat Steve Brooks and Glenn Ross in that event, and it's becoming a three-horse race between them. Bowers four behind Ross, six behind Brooks, who's still leading. So things hotting up now with two events to go and everything to play for. Down by the lake, another old favourite. Well, this is the most traditional of all strongman events, the Húsafelt Stone. Old Icelandic legend has it that if you could lift this odd triangular-shaped thing, you could marry the eldest daughter of the house. And it's called the Húsafelt Stone because that's the noise you make when you drop it on your foot. It's 165 kilograms, that's 24 stone, give or take, and there's no time limit on this event, so if you want to take all day carrying it down the course, you're more than welcome to.
Oh, a big sigh there from Colin Bryce, the first to attempt the Húsafelt Stone. And this is an event we traditionally see at Highland Games all over Scotland during the summer, so Colin knows it well.
Lift.
gets the arms locked around the narrowest part of that huge rock and also taken off a pedestal for the first time rather than having to lift it off the ground. Well, he's going well. Actually, the bottom part of that rock appears to be tucked in his belt. There it is. I'm not sure he's allowed to do that, but he's getting away with it for the time being. And Jamie Reeves there, just telling him to make the first turn, 30 metres covered with ease. Well, maybe a little bit of gamesmanship on behalf of Colin Bryce. And incidentally, tradition also has it that the record distance covered by anybody with this giant stone was by an Icelandic woman. Colin Bryce heading down towards his starting position. That's 60 metres covered. Going well, and the bottom part of the stone tucked even further into his belt. My goodness. I don't know what the judges will say about that. Just short of 75 metres. Colin Bryce absolutely exhausted, and his arms are covered in bruises. Colin Bryce enjoying the experience and enjoying the fact that I think he's pulled a fast one over the judges. The rock is definitely tucked in the top of that belt. I wonder if anybody else has noticed that. Well, Bill Pittuck must have been desperately disappointed with his seventh place in the last event.
Get ready.
The former England strongest man is in sixth place overall, 11 points down on the leader, Steve Brooks. Well, away we go. Offered a charge. Jamie Reeves in attendance. And despite the fact Jamie has given up competition, he's still a huge man himself. Very tight grip by Bill Pittuck. He's got rubber protectors wrapped around his arms as well. That's pretty good thinking. Jukka Ahola put his arm up to say 30 metres covered. Chasing the lead by Colin Bryce. Two and a bit length, 74 metres plus. Now Bill Pittuck is beginning to stagger just a little bit. Oh my goodness, it's like the Ministry of Silly Walks. But he makes the turn. Oh, I thought he was going to drop it. He's just hanging on by his fingertips now. He's going to go past 70. Near to 75, he's gone past Colin Bryce. Bill Pittuck is in the lead. The last few metres must have been absolute agony. 78 metres, 22. He gave everything to that event and it's paid off.
For Jamie Barr, another tough event, 64.85 metres for him. For Brian Bell, even tougher, 43.6. And for Lee Bowers, a very disappointing result. He was in contention, but only 49 metres. And look at Graham Mullin's face. The pain he was in was simply unbearable. He twisted muscles at the base of his spine, and after 30 metres, he'd had more than enough. So just the two leaders to go. In a moment, Steve Brooks, but first, Glenn Ross.
Well, long arms, as we've seen, are very important.
Lift.
I wonder how Glenn Ross is going to get on here. He's certainly got something to rest that rock on, hasn't he? Seems to be going well. Looks pretty comfortable. And I guess one of the difficulties of this event is that you can't see where you're going. So Jamie Reeves going left a bit, right a bit, and at the moment, Glenn Ross is going all right a bit. Round the turn, 30 metres. And this, I think, is going to be a very important event for Glenn Ross. 2 points behind the overall leader, Steve Brooks, and just one event to go. If he can get an advantage here, he could be in with a big, big chance of winning Britain's Strongest Man this year. Now, can he make the turn once again and head off towards Jamie Barr's target of 64 metres in third place? No, he can't. The Northern Ireland man at the moment in fourth place, 59 metres 50.
The stone was heavy. It was just pressing against your chest. I just couldn't breathe. You know, nothing there to breathe with. So I'm disappointed, really.
Steve Brooks, nervous moments for him at the start. If he can win this event, he will go into the last event with a big advantage over the rest. Glenn Ross, down in fourth place at the moment. The second place man. A good tight grip. All these men have got massive grips. They develop that through the huge amount of weightlifting they do. Steve Brooks looks a little unsteady on his feet at the moment, but heading towards 30 metres. Oh, he looks a bit unsteady. Easy does it. He's got a huge chest. But like all the others, I think having difficulty breathing. Now he's losing his grip. He's going off course. Oh, my goodness, he's gone. That's only 40 metres. He's absolutely flat out. And this could make a huge difference to the overall result. The doctor's on there very quickly with oxygen. I hope it's not too much of a problem for Steve Brooks.
It was terrible. Just couldn't breathe at all. I had a good haul of it. I just couldn't breathe. Simple as that.
The competition really is wide open, isn't
it?
Yeah. Your thoughts?
120% for last event now.
And out the blue from nowhere, a win for Bill Pittuck and a great result for Colin Bryce in second place. Glenn Ross in fourth, Steve Brooks seventh.
It's not over yet. So a good event for me next. Fitness event. I'll be there. Thanks to these two boys.
Samuel and Jason, what do they reckon?
They said I'll be number one today on Father's Day. They sent me a card with number one written on, so that was it. That done it, didn't it, boys?
Yeah.
Is Dad going to do it?
Yeah.
Yeah, who's the man?
Dad's man.
Good luck.
Well, if he's going to win, the men ahead are going to have to falter, because realistically, it now looks as though it's head-to-head, Ross against Brooks. Well, the last event is the medley. Carrying a sandbag, flipping a tyre, pushing a truck, and just for fun, there's another 60-stone tyre in the back of it.
Sandbags are pretty straightforward. I'll be flicking them onto my shoulder, pacing myself. The tyre, haven't really done the tyre. I never did it in the heats. But I've learned and watched a lot. The truck is just a basic push.
It's a bit like the heat I had to go through, you know. I had to really turn it on for the heat. It was a fitness event, and I did, and I won my group. So I'm just going to have to do the same here again, just grip my teeth and knuckle down and do the business.
I really need to guarantee a win here to guarantee me third place, so this is it's pride here that's at stake.
We've mentioned all the way through how sporting you all are towards one another. Do you wish them luck just before the start now?
Of course, dear. I hope the best man of the day wins, and I'll be the first to shake his hand. Hopefully it'll be my own. It's not over yet. It's not over till the fat lady sings. Yeah, fat lady.
Well, the men in first and second place, Glenn Ross and Steve Brooks, go in the next heat. So now it's up to Colin Bryce, Brian Bell, Jamie Barr and Graham Mullins on the far side to really try and finish with a flourish. Graham Mullins cites his hero in this sport as Jeff Capes, a former Britain's Strongest Man and World's Strongest Man. They're away well. It's been a baptism of fire at this level of competition for Colin Bryce. Graham Mullins, last to appear over the line for the second sack. At the moment, it's Jamie Barr in the lead. As we've seen with previous events, Jamie Barr moves so well, but so does Colin Bryce. And now this awesome tyre. Mullins taking his time. Barr over just a whisker ahead of Colin Bryce. And you heard what Jamie Barr had to say. He wants to win this event overall to try and get up into the top three. And Barr it is now with the truck, head down, legs pumping. Bryce in second place. Jamie Barr is certainly going to win here. If he can set a fast time, he's got a real chance of moving into third place overall. He wins it. Bryce in second place. Brian Bell in third, Mullins a long, long way back. And Mullins, injured in the last event, he's going to be so disappointed at the end here. The ecstasy of finishing, but the agony of the performance.
We've got to wait and see. It's what Lee Bowers and Bill Pittuck does that matters.
You could yet sneak in to second place, maybe.
Third will do me. I'll be happy with third.
And third place is the most realistic for Jamie. But the battle for the title is between Glenn Ross on the right-hand side and the man next to him, Steve Brooks. Brooks must finish at least two places ahead of Glenn Ross to beat him. Away we go. The end of what has been an enthralling contest. And Bill Pittuck must beat Jamie Barr to stay ahead of him in the overall standings. There's the Northamptonshire man. Oh, he really does move well for a guy who's 20 stones in weight. And it's Steve Brooks who's moving ahead of Glenn Ross. That spells danger, because Lee Bowers is ahead of Ross as well. Now the tyre. What an exhausting way to finish the seventh event. 300 kilos plus, and so difficult to move. Well, Bill Pittuck is still in the lead, but Glenn Ross is coming back. Glenn Ross is just marginally ahead of Steve Brooks, and that's so important to decide the title. Here comes Glenn Ross. If he can stay in this position, he will be Britain's strongest man. Bill Pittuck is in fact slower than Jamie Barr, so Barr will finish in third place. And Glenn Ross wins the title. What a magnificent performance. Steve Brooks in second place. And Lee Bowers trailing home in last place in this final event. That won't do his position on the leaderboard any good at all. But there's only one man today can be crowned as champion, and his name is Glenn Ross.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable.
It was
touching. I did this for my son, Mark, who's born. He's not even a year old. And I did it for him.
It was touch and go for a timeout there, wasn't it?
Can't believe it. I just kept seeing his face. I'm so happy, you know.
Fifth place enough then for Glenn Ross, because his main rival Steve Brooks found it even tougher and came sick. And Jamie Barr's victory was crucial because it pushed him up to third place. Ross 39, Brooks 37, Barr 36, Pittuck 35. They were the top four.
That's my champion there.
Oh, he's just woke up, so yes.
So what's it like then, now that you've done it all? Was it all worthwhile, all the hard work, the training?
Yeah, I give up my day work this year to really, really concentrate on strongman events. Trying to get a bit fitter, because I didn't have the mobility last year. I had the strength, but wasn't mobile enough. I lost a wee bit of weight, I think, but I got 10 times more mobile.
Well, very, very well done.
Thanks.
Britain's strongest man. You don't need a hand to hold the baby.
No. No.
Well done.
Yes!
And so after several days of grueling competition at Alton Towers, the Energizer Battery Trophy went to Glenn Ross. Ireland's strongest man was now Britain's strongest man. So that's it from Alton Towers. Hope you enjoyed this year's final. And the next challenge for Britain's strongest man is to see if in a few months' time he can become the world's strongest man. And for that, we'll see you in Malta.
You may not have quite the muscle, but Brad Pitt fans are in for a treat tonight, because BBC One has a movie double bill kicking off at 9:30 with the sci-fi thriller 12 Monkeys, co-starring Bruce Willis, followed by more Pitt action at 11:35 in Across the Tracks.